If you're looking for this perfect house where you have an ideal balance between living space for entertainment as well as a very functional family home, this, ladies and gentlemen, is it.
Welcome back to another episode of Walkthrough with the Janies. Today we are here in District 5, Springwood Heights, and this is where we're going to show you this corner terrace. So we are about 9 minutes walk to Pasir Panjang MRT, and that's also where you have Biju, and that's where you have your nearest amenities such as Hau Mart, where you can do your grocery shopping. It's surrounded by all these nature parks. Just behind me, you have Kent Ridge Park. And of course, further down, you have the Southern Ridges as well.
There's only one row of houses in front of the house we're going to show you. The other nice benefit here is that we are actually on elevated land and there's actually no through traffic here. So it's a very quiet and serene neighborhood.
Now this corner terrace that we're going to show you spans approximately 2,946 square feet. Now the built up of this land is
approximately 5,800 square feet, which is double the original size of the house when it was originally built here.
You have a total of 4 huge bedrooms. And on top of that, you have 2 storerooms, one of which can be converted into an entertainment room. Separate from that, you still have a helper's room as well. You have 2 kitchens here. You have an indoor and outdoor kitchen. You have 2 outdoor patios, and you have a living area as well as a dining area completely separate from each other.
And you have 2 studies. One of which is in a loft. Whenever you're looking for a landed property, what is the first thing that's important? It's the plot of land itself, right? So here we are. We have an elevated area of the house and we have a massive wall which is approximately 85 feet in length and we have a massive frontage of 10.7 meters. Now, here is a door. This leads to a separate level. So once we will do the house, you can actually see that this can serve like a dual key house. This level accesses the helper's room. There's an additional room. There's a living room. You have a kitchenette. You have a lot of parking here, which is important because as we will see later, this is a perfect entertainment house. So we're right now in front of the house. The frontage here is 10.7 meters. Direction is facing almost due north, slightly northeast.
Facing out and facing in, it is south.
So this house was actually rebuilt by the renowned DP Architects. Now, let me show you the first level of the house and Sharon will show you the rest. Come, let's take a look. One thing you are definitely going to love about this house is the outdoor area. So you have this patch of a garden here. When you come in, you have a lot of entertainment area and outside all this area is sheltered, which gives you a lot of space to entertain in the evening. All this is sheltered. We have one sort of living dining area here. And it's connected to the back, right to the other side where you have got another dining area. So the nice thing about this house is you've got actually 270 degrees views and that gives you a lot of natural light in the house. The elevation makes it breezy and private. They say you can only make the first impression once. So what's my first impression walking into this house? You feel very welcome. Very comfortable, lots of natural air, lots of natural light. You have these windows which overlook the patio, they overlook the garden. It's very calming, really a great space here just to sit out if you want to even have an informal discussion. And the other section is actually where you have the dining. But before we go to the dining, look at what the architect did with the staircase. It's very clever because he used glass panels, which means that you have a lot of natural light. Not only you have the great greenery views, but the staircase is not dark. As a result, this whole house has this very comfortable level of natural light throughout the day. So obviously this leads to the bedrooms and the downstairs, actually just below the staircase, it's such a huge storage room that you could actually repurpose it as an entertainment room or man cave. And that's where you also have like an independent one bedroom apartment with a helper's room, living room, own bedroom, even own garden, and its separate access. Now here, this is where we have the gourmet kitchen. So you can see the house is designed around entertainment. If you want to just have a coffee, you have this counter here, and this is more for formal dining. I like how this is separated from the living room. So if somebody enters the door, they don't walk straight onto your dining table. They don't see this portion of the house. And look what the architect did here. He's done these doors which kind of open so you can adjust the angle if you prefer to have al fresco. But if you prefer the comfort of aircon, then you can fully enclose this space, and there's a separate air conditioning unit. In fact, there are three air conditioning units for this whole area. And look at this. So this is the part where you can have your al fresco dining. Again, you can even raise the bamboo chicks if you want to have that full-blown view experience. And the nice thing here is the architect cleverly used this elevation, so you actually have just a full view of greenery, good separation from your neighbors. And in fact, the back wall here, it doesn't go straight and it's not shared with your neighbor. It's actually separated by a drain, which gives you that added privacy as well. And here you have a full-blown kitchen. If you want to do your heavy duty cooking, this is the place. This closes up. But in addition to this, we actually can close this whole section off so you will not have any cooking smells wafting into your dining and living room. Now let's check out upstairs.
We're here on the second story of the house. So over on this side, you do have a common bathroom. This common bathroom is actually meant for your guests. Behind me, this is the first bedroom. It comes ensuite. Now let's take a look. Just look at how massive the size is of this bedroom. It is very squarish in shape and you have plenty of space to put your study, your bed, whatever it is. And the nice thing that I like about this is actually if you were to look outside, you do have a mini balcony space as well. And this is nice because again, this is elevated, so you're slightly higher and it actually overlooks all the way out to where you have the checkpoint currently, which will move away to Tuas, and then you would have a nice view for a while before they start building things on the opposite side. So on this side, you do have your bathroom area. You do have this sunken bath that is actually very popular nowadays in a lot of developments, especially Far East ones. And we are now heading to the other side. So yes, it's only two rooms, but they are huge. So can you imagine if you decide to reconfigure how much space you have here? So this is the second bedroom. Now this bedroom comes with plenty of shelving behind me. So this is a bookworm bedroom. Have a nice study area here. Again, very big in size. And if you want to, of course, you can change this to a king size bed if you wish. And you can reconfigure this space a bit. But again, the main point here is you have plenty of space in this room. And because of the size of the windows here, just look at how much natural light comes into the bedroom. This is beautiful. So this is my favorite floor in the house. This is the third story, and let me show you the most epic room in the entire house. Now follow me. Just take a look at the views from here. Because it's so high up, you can actually see across all the way to the current checkpoint in front. But what's nice is that you see that if you were to rebuild this house, for example, you can no longer have this height anymore because of height restrictions. So this is one of the plus points of this house. And of course, as you can see, there are stairs here, and what this actually leads to is your study area up top. This is a loft, so you can see how much of the, because of the height and everything, can you imagine just doing your work upstairs? This is just beautiful. This is my favorite spot in this house. And even with the ceiling here, it doesn't compromise the height you have here of your bed. And the view is just, wow, it's amazing. So over here you have the master bathroom. Of course, it comes with his and hers sink. Again, it comes with a sunken bath here. And I mean, the view across the whole of this floor is amazing. You do have a lot of storage spaces here. This is the wardrobes. Don't tell me it's not enough because it is huge. And behind this area, you have a separate storeroom that you can house even more clothes if you need to. And this door here actually leads to the study room, which was connected from the front. It's as good as having another bedroom, depending on how you want to use it. So yeah, we're back here. And that is the third story.
So let's summarize. What are some of the great features of this house? For me personally, I just love the whole squarish land. I like the fact that I've got 270 degrees views, and I love this whole living entertainment area, how it flows. It's like an unobstructed flow, yet the living and dining areas are totally separate. I've got lots of light. I've got plenty of cars that I can park along the side of the road, so when I have guests, it's not a problem. I just love how the architect thought this through. In fact, every time I walk through this house, it kind of grows on me. How about
you? Yeah, it's the same with me. I feel like the more I'm here, the more I see that it's a very livable home. Yes, I think it's also very suitable for multi-generation families because each of the rooms actually are equipped with a lot of space. You have a bathroom as well, so it's easy to split the house between the different generations. And what is nice here is, of course, because of where we are located, is near the Greater Southern Waterfront. So we will enjoy the benefits that comes with the rejuvenation of this site as well. And how close it is to actually nature in this part. This is something that you won't get in every single of the landed areas in Singapore.
You can actually hear birds singing because, once again, I stress, because I think this is a part which is often just undervalued and not really noticed. There's hardly any traffic here.
Yeah.
I can hear
really
birds
quiet.
Singing. I can kind of get this very natural, peaceful feeling, which I think is really something that you must have in a house.
And the last thing that I think is like really wow is actually the master, because look at the ceiling height you have there. This is something you cannot rebuild anymore because of height restrictions here.
Yeah, you wouldn't be able to get a house of this size here for sure. And I like the fact that you don't really have a bomb shelter here.
Yeah.
So that's also additional space saving. So really the space is optimized, and I would just repurpose that room underneath us. You know,
yeah.
It's just a
the two
just
separate entrances.
Yeah,
right?
It's just such a nice man cave you could do right down there. So if you are keen, because there's still some surprises in this house, feel it firsthand, come in, take a look, give any one of us a call.
And we'll see you on
the next
video.
One.